Hello everybody, welcome back to our channel. I'm Dr. Mel from City Skin Clinic, and today I thought we'd have a little chat about chemical peels for skin of colour and which peels work well and which peels to avoid. This is a really important topic. It's something obviously quite close to my heart, and I feel it's important to put as much accurate information out there as possible for not just our patients, but people all around the world who are looking for this sort of information. So please, before we continue, if you're enjoying our content and want to see a bit more, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. You can hit the notification bell so that you kind of get to know when our next video drops. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up at the end. So why is this topic important? Well, we know that actually there are certain skin care products and ingredients, and although they do a great job, it depends. They can also be quite harmful if they're used in the wrong setting. Tone is one of those. So we know that skin of color, and specifically sort of if you think of the Fitzpatrick scale, that's in particular skin types 5 and 6, these are sort of brown and deeper skin tones. So in more melanin rich skin, you sometimes need to be careful with certain ingredients, and chemical peels is one of the biggest things to be aware of. And when I talk about chemical peels, I'll also mention this applies to exfoliants that you can also use at home as well. So glycolic acid peels, this is probably one of the most famous peels. It's actually quite a good workhorse peel. Glycolic acid is particularly useful as a peeling agent because it's a really small molecule. It goes quite deep into the skin and it can penetrate. And it's great for things like addressing lines and wrinkles, improving skin texture. It's also really good for evening out skin tone in the case of hyperpigmentation. So it's fantastic for aging skin. It's fantastic in people with acne scarring as well. And it kind of gives a more radiant complexion, smoother skin, all the things that, you know, most of us really strive for. The problem with glycolic acid is in more melanin-rich skin tones, it can actually cause post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. So the exact opposite of what we're looking for, and that can end up really damaging the skin, and it's a particularly awful thing to get if the main intention was to improve your skin itself, the appearance of it. So, It's something that can be treated, but obviously takes quite some time, and it's something that all clinicians should be aware of. Everyone involved in kind of treating skin should be aware of this and should be looking to avoid it, and that's particularly important when you think of patients with skin of colour. So what are the alternatives? So one of the things you can do is opt for different peels. So we know superficial peels like lactic acid, mandelic acid, malic acid, these are less likely to cause hyperpigmentation, and so you can safely use these in people with skin of color. If someone's got oily skin, salicylic acid can also be used, and if someone suffers from acne, retinol-based peels can also be used safely. So it's not that it's limiting options, there's a wide variety of peels that can be used, and that aren't associated with post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation the way that glycolic acid is. Glycolic acid itself can be used, but you really have to prepare someone with skin of color for that. It's something that if someone suffers or is known to suffer from post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation, I'd be inclined to give it a miss. But if someone hasn't had post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation in the past, but you want to be cautious, then preparing someone for glycolic acid peels can help. One of the ways you can prepare them is by trying them out for a while on those other peels that I mentioned, like the lactic acid peel, and seeing how they get on with that, and then starting with a lower strength glycolic acid peel, and then over time stepping it up, because peels are usually course of treatment, so you can do that. The other thing that you can do and is worth doing is putting someone on an at-home prep kit, so one that maybe has a glycolic acid as a toner in a really, really low concentration, and that prepares the skin for glycolic acid so it gets used to it. And even then, I would still, when doing a professional peel, start with a lower concentration peel. And with all chemical peels, you should always do a patch test on someone who's not had these peels, especially before, just to make sure that there is no kind of adverse reaction. So you would do it obviously in an area that's not very visible. So that's one way you can incorporate chemical peels, and particularly glycolic peels, is by having this gradual approach. The other is you can avoid these peels entirely and go either for the superficial peels I previously mentioned, or if you're looking for a medium depth, a more involved, deeper peel, then actually for someone with oily skin of colour, then a modified Jesner peel is fantastic, and you could also use that with a salicylic acid peel. It already has a salicylic acid in the modified Jesner, but sometimes we combine them together. That's a really good way to kind of get the most out of these peels over time. The other thing that you can do is for someone with skin of colour, but it's dry skin or it's normal skin, you could do a TCA peel. And again, TCA peels will help with hyperpigmentation, they'll help with lines and wrinkles, they'll help with skin texture. So there is quite a bit that can be done. The other, if someone has skin of color and they have sensitive skin, so as well as things like lactic acid peels, you can also use enzyme peels. In that situation, these are a gentler way to offer skin peeling. The things that you absolutely should do is, firstly, if you have any of these peels, your practitioner should be giving you information about what to look out for. So after the peel, you know, skin may be a little bit tight, it may be a little bit red, it may even feel and look great if they've put serum and moisturizer afterwards. You absolutely, absolutely must make sure that you're using sunscreen immediately after the peel and then moving forwards, because that's another way that you can get sun damage and hyperpigmentation, and skin is even more prone to that after a chemical peel. Other things to do, as well as protecting your skin, is making sure that you avoid other irritants during that time. So, for example, if you're someone who is using tretinoin regularly, if you're someone who's using retinol regularly, or even if you're someone who's using an at-home exfoliant like the, you know, glycolic acid or salicylic acid, lactic, anything like that, you will be required to stop these before you have the peel, and you may be required also for a period afterwards. So it's really important to have that plan so that you don't irritate the skin and cause it to be more prone to developing post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. So in terms of other treatments, for example, if you're receiving laser therapy, then this is something that you're going to have a gap between when you have laser and when you have peels. And that's something, again, to discuss with your practitioner. It's really important, again, not to stress the skin out too much, and because you can develop post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation if you overdo this, or you use things incorrectly. And it may be that if you're receiving laser therapy somewhere else, not where you have your peel, it's about letting your laser therapist know what type of peel that you've had in the course of that, because they may need to adapt your laser regime based on this, as well as the timing. So I hope from this video, the big take home is there's a huge, huge amount of options for chemical peels for any skin type and also for skin of color. It's just really important to have a discussion with your clinician, and it should be someone who understands some of the risks with certain peels and certain skin products that can have on skin of color, and that they can avoid this and they can help you put together a program that's going to be safe and also give you the effects that you're really looking for, the outcomes that you desire. I hope you found this video useful. Please leave a comment below if you have any questions. I have left some useful links to pages below that I think will be useful for people who want to learn a little bit more about skin of color and the precautions that can be taken and what the best products are for professional treatments and what sort of thing to avoid. If you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel and check out the rest of our videos.